Hajira, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Sir, you can share after the welcome note, sir.
Okay, sir. Okay.
I just now stopped sharing yours.
Okay.
Okay, after the welcome address, we can share.
Okay. Okay. No problem.
Good morning to all. Welcome back. Happy to step into the sixth day of the 7 days webinar series organized by IQSU of Erode Arts and Science College on the theme Quality Enhancing Strategies to Confront the Challenges of the Revised Assessment and Accreditation Framework of NAAC. Today we have with us a well-experienced professor, Dr. G.V. Gopinath from Armugam Pillai Sidayammal College, Tirupattur, to address on ensuring quality institutional provisions through the e-governance of academic, administrative, and organizational aspects. Before we enter the technical session, Dr. M. Hajira Banu, Assistant Professor of Commerce and member of IQASC, will present the welcome note and introduce the resource person. I invite you, madam, please.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. It's a glorious moment to extend your wishes to everyone who are connected in the virtual platform. A very happy morning to all. It's a great pleasure indeed for me to welcome everyone to the sixth day of 7 days webinar series organized by IQASC of Erode Arts and Science College. I extend a warm welcome to our beloved Chairman and Secretary of Erode Arts and Science College, Sadhana Chimmal, Thiru K.K. Balusami sir, a great visionary. I welcome you, sir. It's a true pleasure for me to welcome the most respected principal of our college, Dr. R. Venkatachalam sir, who always shows a right path. I welcome you, sir. It's a great privilege for me to welcome most respected controller of examination, Dr. M. Venkatachalam sir. We welcome you, sir. I'm pleased to share that the distinguished guest, Dr. G. V. Gopinath sir, assistant professor of zoology, Armugam Pillai Sidayammal College, Tirupattur, has honored with his presence today. I wholeheartedly welcome you, sir. I would like to welcome an enthusiastic IQASC coordinator, Dr. S.M. Jayasudha, and energetic IQASC member. I would like to welcome everyone wholeheartedly. I would like to register my welcome to principals, HODs, faculty of our college, and from various colleges who are connected with us in this virtual platform. The event could have been possible with the support of each and everyone. I welcome you all for the topic for discussion of sixth day of webinar, ensuring quality institutional provisions through e-governance of academic, administrative, and organizational aspects. I welcome you all. It's a time to introduce a resource person. It's a great honor for me to introduce an eminent resource person of the day, Dr. G.V. Gopinath sir, Assistant Professor of Zoology, Armugam Pillai Sidayammal College, Tirupattur. He is working there since 2008. He has presented more than 30 research papers in various national and international conferences. He has published 10 of his research papers in reputed international science journals. 7 of his research papers were published in the conference proceedings. He has published a book named Recent Friends on Future Perspective of Bioscience. He has deposited 4 microbial gene sequences in the National Center for Biotechnology Information, USA. He has served as a vice principal and IQASC coordinator in Armugam Pillai Sidayammal College. At present, he holds many responsibility and positions in the college. Some of them are member in Institutional UGC Planning Board, Institutional Mentor of MOOC, Convener of Insurance Governance Cell, Member in Student Internship Committee, Member in Research Advisory and Ethical Committee, Convener for RUSA. He holds some of the honorary positions like he is an Advisory Committee Member for Vetangudi Bird Sanctuary Forest Department of Government of Tamil Nadu, Honorary District President, Tamil Nadu Science Forum, Sivagangai District. His special interest is natural resource management, biodiversity, conservation, medicinal plants, Indian medicines, ecological farming, People Participatory Research Program. It's a great honor for us, sir, for your presence. I welcome you, sir. Now I hand over the session to Dr. G.V. Gopinath, sir. Please, sir.
Thank you, madam. Thank you. Hello, everyone. This is Dr. Gopinath from Department of Zoology of Mumbai Sitiya Mal College. And before we go to the session, I would like to appreciate the efforts of the chairman, the principal, and IQC coordinator, and Professor Murugananthan and Dr. Azira Banu for organizing this wonderful webinar. And today we are going to see the e-governance of an educational institution. So, I'm not going to explain A to Z of e-governance of all aspects, because even a single slide, it will take 2 to 3 hours to explain a complete e-governance particular system. So I will give you some idea and what are the area in which an educational institution can apply the e-governance. So in simple term, e-governance is nothing but the application of information technology for delivering various services and information exchange, communication, transactions, and interaction of various standalone systems. The question behind, the question in front of us is, why should we go for e-governance? Because e-governance gives you the facility to access any data from anywhere at any time, and you have the real-time access provisions, quick access. If a document have billions of pages and you want to extract a particular information, it will just retrieve the data in a matter of second, even billions of pages containing a document. So such as quick access, we can get it from e-governance, and it requires less capital, less manpower and storage space, and the safety and security of the data. We can store the data instead of conventional type of racks and bureaus and files, we can store the data in the cloud. And we can also deliver the information instantly to millions of people. So these are the major benefits under the e-governance system. Almost all institutions are just looking for the accreditation assessment, maybe NAC. And NAC has suggested 7 quality indicated frameworks. We otherwise call it as criteria. And e-governance comes under the 6 criteria: governance, leadership, and management. These 7 criteria are measured by 34 key indicators. And the key indicators are further divided into 36 quality matrices and 79 quality quantity matrices in case of universities. And in case of autonomous colleges, it is 35 and 72, and aided colleges 35 and 58. So on the whole, if you want to get a good score, our entire concentration should be on these 93 or 107 matrices. So it is not used when you focus on a particular aspect. For example, you focus on only infrastructure. The infrastructure criteria, it gives you 100 marks. Okay. If you add more, if you consist more and more building, you cannot get even 1 mark above 100. So once the bottle is filled, there is no sense of filling it again and again. So our focus should be on the entire 93 or 107 quality and the quantitative matrices. So here the e-governance comes to our risk. We can apply the e-governance in all the 93 or 107 quality and the quantitative matrices. Okay. and implementation of e-governance in the area of operation. In so these are some of the areas in which we can apply the e-governance. For example, the planning and the development, the academic aspects, administrative aspects, finance and accounts, student support and progress in research and extension activities, feedback system and stakeholder participations. So in these major areas, we can apply the e-governance. We will see one by one. For example, on an academic aspects, starting from the student admission, student enrollment, and then student profile preparation, teaching and process, evaluation, performance and learning outcomes, the student feedback and satisfaction survey. In this area, we can apply the e-governance. So almost all colleges, they have started online admission. Government has also instructed to continuous online admission. So every college or institution, they should have a provision for the students in the college website to download their application, to download the brochure, and there should be a payment gateway, and there should be some program outcome and course outcome and all. So that students can go through that and select the course, and they can download the application and pay through the payment gateway. So the e-governance can start from the admission. And another important area is in teaching learning evaluation, how we are going to manage the teaching learning system under e-governance. So it is through online classes, online assignment, and online assessment, online quiz, online discussion, online virtual meetings, and online examinations. So these are the area comes under the teaching learning and evaluation. We can do it with the help of e-governance. So instead of going each aspect separately, all these aspects are covered under one umbrella that is called Google Classroom. So Google Classroom is a wonderful free tool available in Google, through which they can do all those things. There is a paid option also. In the paid option, we have some little more advantages, but it is available in the available to everyone as a free software. In Google Classroom, actually, it is nothing but online file sharing system between a teacher and a student. The Google Classroom is governed by Google Docs, then Google Slides, Google Sheets, Gmail, and Google Calendar. You can synchronize all your activity with the Google Calendar and manage the teacher and the student. A teacher, each and every teacher can create their own Google Classroom, and they can generate a class code, and they can invite their student through the class code or a link, and they can conduct the class. And the teachers can give assignment and evaluate the assignments, and the assignment due dates are the teacher can synchronize with the Google Calendar. So those, for example, today is 27th, the assignment should be submitted at 11 p.m. and 59 minutes. So just like that, you can pick the date, time, and all. And your teacher can monitor the progress of each student through revision of his ISTEFA document. And Google Classroom has access to laptop, PC, and even Android mobiles. So teachers and students, they have the option to attach files to the assignment, which can they can view and they can edit. So in fact, in my perception, it is better than a conventional classroom. Google Classroom is better than a conventional classroom, provided if you have a good internet facility and at least a minimum a laptop with a minimum configuration. And teacher has the option to monitor the progress in the comments and edit the student assignment. And the assignments and online exams can be graded by the teacher, and whereas the graded assignments can be only by the teacher only and not the students. And you can archive all your courses. Once it is archived, the teachers and students can view it but not able to make any changes. And very important thing is in Google Classroom, it does not show any advertisement in its interface for students and teacher. And user data will not be scanned or used for advertisement. It is very, very important aspect. So in addition to Google Classroom, we have a number of other options to govern the teaching and learning evaluation under e-governing system. And some of them are interactive presentation, Jamboard, Whiteboard, Insert Learning, and you need a wiki page, Google Forms, Google Slides, and Google Sheet. It is very difficult to explain each and every activity, but I will show you one or two. For example, so this is nothing but the interactive PowerPoint presentation. Usually teachers use PowerPoint presentation, but this PowerPoint presentation is interactive PowerPoint presentation in which you can, for example, you can share your PowerPoint online to the students. And the first question from your PowerPoint, did you learn this topic earlier in your school days? So in the bottom, there is a provision where students can write their answer. So the next interactive slide is type any two things you already know about the fat soluble vitamin, for example. So student can type, if they know the answer, they can type here. And you may ask a question in the PowerPoint presentation also. Of course, it is a virtual class, students are somewhere and you are in one place and you are directly sharing your online presentation. And so you can raise the question to the student, for example, meat is one of the source of vitamin B12, and this statement is true. Student can click true or false. Okay. You can put a question whether the students are agree or disagree. For example, in chicken there is no microprobe. Then students may be asked to write. The student, they will just agree or disagree. Disagree, just click the button. Okay. And you may ask a student, you may give them a mind map exercise. For example, in the center, I have written vitamin A is essential for, that's all. So in one side, I have written it's essential for normal vision. So in the other three sides, students may be asked to write their answer. And when the presentation is going on, you can ask a student to present the stress level. So you can measure their stress level. The students can select any one of these. Some students may just say, keep going and understand. And some students they may have some doubts. So if they press, I am little confused, then you can talk with them, so, or they can raise their questions. Okay. And you can ask, do you feel comfortable sharing your thoughts out right now? And students are able to type their answer in the bottom portion of the slides. Okay. And in the middle of the session, you can ask, how well did you like this lesson? And students, they can choose anyone. So some you can put some two or three things and ask a student to connect the fact. So for example, what connects these two, these concepts? I mean, on one side, there is a statement called optimum pressure in the cerebrospinal fluid, and another side, there is a statement called ataxia. So what connects these two concepts? The student have to, suppose they are supposed to write of vitamin A. So in vitamin A is essential for to maintain the optimum pressure in the cerebrospinal fluid. If it is not there, then the bird will come under the condition called ataxia. So it is a type of interaction, okay? And they can also put their feeling. And you can ask the student to summarize what they just learned. And you can ask the student to give some conclusions from the slides. And you can ask a student to give the, some observations from the slides. And suppose if a student will give a statement and other students, they are differed from that statement. So they can select any one of this figure and they can give their suggestion also. And you can ask the student to draw lines to match the facts. So here the student can, for example, this is the condition called xerophthalmia. Student can draw a line and they can match the onset. And you can also ask the student to write some clinical symptoms of a particular, comment on a particular slide or the lesson. And at the end of the lesson, ask a student about the session. And you can ask them to reflect on the day's activity. What did they like and what they didn't like? What was easy and what was hard? And at the end, the students may be asked to put their doubts also in the slides. So you can conclude the your PowerPoint presentation with a slide. So this is a typical example of how you can govern the teaching and learning and the evaluation with a simple PowerPoint. So in simple PowerPoint, you can't do it, but it is a provision given in Google. So interactive PowerPoint presentation, you can do with this. Okay.
Sir, excuse me, sir. Your slide is not moving, sir.
ஸ்லைடு உங்களுக்கு மூவ் ஆகலையா?
நோ சார், அந்த லிங்க்லயே தான் சார் இருக்கு.
ஐயோ, அப்படியா? முன்னாடியே சொல்லிருக்கலாமே, நான் நிறைய காமிச்சிட்டேனே அதுல.
ஓகே சார், we thought there's a problem sir in connection, so the link alone was available. Could you please go again sir? No problem, we'll just go through.
Just a minute, just a minute. Ma'am?
Sir?
Can you able to see, can you able to see the slides?
No, sir, no, sir.
Slides are, slides Savita? We can see, sir. The link has been highlighted. but no, it's no, not no. open. It's not open. Okay, so next slide we can go, sir.
No, no. What slide now you see? Vitamins?
Sir, interactive presentation with the link highlighted. It has been selected.
Now can you see that slide moving?
No, sir. The next slide, please.
Just a minute, sir. Just a minute. Just a minute, sir.
Sir, whether you want to show the document in the link, sir?
Yeah.
Let me share it.
Okay, how will you share it? Okay, sir.
Sir, is this a slide, sir?
Oh, is this a slide? Okay. Ma'am, now can you able to see the slide vitamin?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Is it now moving?
Yes, sir. It's moving.
Moving. Okay. Sir, you minimize the screen.
This one, sir.
Okay. Actually, the slide is not moving. Only you can able to move that slide.
Yes, sir. Since I am sharing.
Okay. When I say next, you just move. So this is nothing but the interactive PowerPoint presentation, in which you can share your slides directly with the students. Next. So your students are somewhere and you are in one place. You are directly sharing your PowerPoint presentation, but it is an interactive PowerPoint presentation through which you can govern the teaching learning system. For example, you can ask a student, did you learn this topic earlier in your school days? And students, they can answer at the bottom of the slide. There is a provision and they can type. So next. So you can ask a student to type anything so they already know about that particular topic. They can type here. Okay. So next. And you can ask the question, and the student may be asked, for example, meat is one of the sources of vitamin B12, and his statement is true or false. You can ask, and from your laptop, and students, just on seeing from their laptop, they can answer it. So next. And you can give a statement and ask the student to say whether they agree or not. Next. 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 So this is a mind mapping exercise. So while you're presenting a PowerPoint, you can ask the student, you can give them a mind map exercise. For example, in the center, I have given a statement, vitamin A is essential for. So in that side, I put an answer for normal vision. And students are requested to some more answer in other part of the figure. Okay, next, next. And while you presenting your PowerPoint presentation, you can measure the student's stress level. Students, they can choose any one of the figure and let you know their state, mental state. Next. Also ask the student whether they are comfortable sharing their thoughts. Next. 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 So in the middle of the presentation, you can ask a student how well did they like this lesson, and they can answer. Next. 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 So you can ask the student to make connections. You create a slide like this and ask the student to make a connection. For example, in left side, I have written that optimum pressure in the cerebros for spinal fluid, and the right side, ataxia. And student have to put an answer in the middle box, which connect these two aspects. For example, vitamin A. Next. They can express their feeling. Next. And you can ask the student to summarize what they have just learned from the previous slides. Next. 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 And you can ask the student to draw some conclusions. So these are all things, it's a real-time access things. And while you're presenting a PowerPoint itself, they can ask the students to give their suggestions, conclusions, and remarks. Next. 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 And you can ask student about their observation. For example, you can ask them the clinical symptoms of vitamin D deficiency in the poultry. And in the bottom of the slide, there is a small window in which a student can type. When they type, you will be able to see in your system. Next. And suppose if a student expresses a particular point and other students are not agree with that, so you can ask that and students can reply whether they agree or not. Next. 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 In the middle of the presentation, you ask a student to draw lines to match the answer. For example, this is the first picture is xerophthalmia, and student may be asked to draw a line and connect the answer given in the right side. Next. Next, 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 and you can ask a student to write important points of the slides. Next. 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 You can ask a student to put the doubts, and at the, you can end the presentation. With the next, you can end the presentation with the water thing. So it is an interactive PowerPoint presentation through which you can govern the teaching, learning, and the evaluation. At the time, you can teach, you can evaluate the students. So like this, there are some more provisions also, PowerToon and insert learning. So insert learning is nothing but you can open any web page, and with the help of, when you open a web page, and insert learning is a Chrome extension, and if you install that Chrome extension, and this figure will appear. So from this you can highlight a particular topic, and you can ask students a question. You can add a sticky note, and in the sticky note you can add some videos or some images, and students may be asked to write their question. They may be asked to add the image or video to the page, and you can create a discussion forum on the web page itself. So you can simply convert your web page into a interactive web page. So it is a very, very interesting thing, and it is available in the insert learning. And you can share the interactive web page with your Google Classroom also. And another governance in teaching learning evaluation is admission and online publication of result, then biometric attendance and bulk SMS systems and WhatsApp groups. Just you can form WhatsApp groups of students, and through the WhatsApp group you can send your teaching material. You can ask a student to return that material. You can send some videos, and also nowadays after Corona. Corona had, in fact, it makes some radical change in the teaching learning system. Almost from starting from the schools and college and professional institution, they started online classes. And a simple tool, one of the simple tool is WhatsApp tool. Okay. And other thing is Swayam. Swayam is an online portal available for the student for free courses. So it has two type of courses. One is MOOC, massive open online course. It covers from 9th standard to postgraduate. And another one is NPTEL, in which thousands of courses are available with 20,000 video hours and more than 450 million viewers. And it is designed exclusively for the engineering section. So Swayam is developed by Ministry of Human Resources Development and NPTEL, IIT Madras, and Google. So it has the MOOC course are available from class 9 to postgraduate, and you can access the class at anywhere, anytime, with any convenient time. Okay. So it has four type of quadrants: one, video lectures and reading material, quiz programs, and it also has a discussion forum. The courses are offered at free of course, and to get the certificate you have to write an exam. Okay. And UGC has already announced the credit transfer mechanism. So once you complete your course in Swayam or NPTEL, the credit can be converted to the regular course. Already some IITs and some universities adapted that, and previously it was 20%. Now UGC announced you can transfer the credit up to 40%. You can transfer the credit from the MOOC and NPTEL courses to your regular courses. And very interesting thing is some 20% of the audience are the faculty members. And the next e-governing system, it comes from the student feedback and from all stakeholders. So we should have a feedback mechanism, and we should collect the feedback from the students and parents, alumni, and other stakeholders. So for that we should have some provision in our website. For example, this is our college website, in which we have given the feedback forms and alumni form. So student can directly click the form and they can give the feedback on the curriculum, the course design, and the faculty, and the facilities available in the institution. So so student can give their feedback, and the entire feedback will be converted into digital data, and you can instantly you can arrive at a conclusion. So these are some. some of the important e-governing system, and this is a very, very, very important one. That is student satisfaction survey. When you go for accreditation assessment with the NAC, you have to give the email ID of all the student, and they will select some randomly select 20% of the student, and they will send a questionnaire. So they collect the feedback from directly from the students. If the students are failed to give the feedback, then they will drop the peer team visit. So this feedback collection is very, very important. So we have to inculcate the culture of digital feedback system among the students. So suppose if you want to go for the accreditation assessment after 1 or 2 years, so you have to start from this year also. So every semester or every teacher, you have to collect the student, and it is the duty of the IQAC to consolidate the feedback, and they have to come to arrive at a conclusion, and they have to take appropriate action with the input given by the students. So this student satisfaction survey is an important point in NAC accreditation process. So this is an excellent e-governing system for an educational institution, and it is also proposed by MHRD, the National Academic Depository. Each and every student, they can, it is a digital depository. Student, they have to get an ID from the institute, and the institution will have to register from the NAD portal, and they can generate ID for each student. So students can upload their certificates. So there is no question of the certificate is lost, you have to go to the police station and give an IFAR complaint, and so many things are there. So here you can upload your certificate in the cloud. And if you give the email ID to the university will also upload student mark sheet, degree, everything in the NAD portal, so that student can easily access, download their certificate. And even after completing their graduation or postgraduate graduation from an institute, suppose if they go for a work in the company, and the company is asking for a certificate verification. I have seen and heard so many verification mails are pending in many institutes. So this is an excellent way. Suppose for verification of the certificate, students have to give their NAD ID, and when they intend to verify, it will send a authentication mail requesting the student to authenticate. So once the student authenticate, the company can open in the portal, and they can verify the digital certificates uploaded in the NAD portal. So it is an excellent system to govern all your academic records. So for NAD, you have to register in the NAD portal, and you have to get your ID and generate password, upload your certificate, and institution can give the details to the university to upload the certificates to the NAD portal. You can share, verify, and download the certificate. And this is another excellent e-governing system, very useful in case of research. So plagiarism nowadays it is very, very important. You can't simply copy and write an article. So intentionally or unintentionally. So Grammarly is an excellent software offered by Google, through which you can correct your text and spelling, grammar, and plagiarism. You can customize your email. Grammarly is available in the extension form. So once you install Grammarly in the Google Chrome, then your email will be automatically monitored by the Grammarly software. For example, in this text, Grammarly has shown the mistakes. So and totally there are 8 mistakes, and it will also give you a suggestion so that you can correct your text from the email. Suppose you write an article, you just select a particular article, paste it in the in Word form, Word file. So in Word file, once you install the Grammarly, you can see the logo in the menu bar. So you have to click the Grammarly logo and it will open a blank document. You have to paste your material. For example, one material has posted. So here, Grammarly has suggested there are 31 alerts, 31 mistakes. And the score is only 41% score. And at the bottom of the document, you can see plagiarism, okay? So Grammarly will suggest you the alternate words, alternate the right grammar and all, okay? So from the same document, so if you select the Grammarly, if you select the plagiarism, it shows in this particular page, there are 16% plagiarism. And what portion of the article comes under the plagiarism, it clearly underline and highlight that. And it also show this particular portion is taken from the Wikipedia. So you can correct the text from the online itself. And say, for example, after correcting it, now the plagiarism is zero, the article is 100% original. So this Grammarly is available in as a free tool as well as a paid tool. In free tool, you can check 1,000 words, 1,000 words, okay? Whereas in paid, the software is, it comes around 11,000 rupees for 1 year, and it's a multi-user tool. You can use this Grammarly software for writing articles. It will be very useful for the student to write the projects, even the faculty members to write the research articles, and research students to write their thesis. And Grammarly will check their document with billions of documents available in the web pages, and it will give you the plagiarism. So with a very simple money, just 11,000 rupees per annum per year, an institution can cover 0% plagiarism with a simple tool. So recently the University Grant Commission has issued a public notice that even self-plagiarism is not allowed. And in administrative aspect, MIS is a very important system. Many institutions have installed MIS. So MIS, it contains three major components. One is the hardware and software, and another one is people. So it connect all the three things and give you the best solution. So the MIS will look after the online admission, the payment gateway, the mobile apps and bulk SMS, and it can maintain attendance, financial management, salary, payslip, all your leave, and mark evaluation. And the MIS also has a NAC data spreadsheet. So you can directly, the IQAC need not collect the data from each faculty member, and they have to consolidate, and they have to, they need not upload in the document. The MIS has a NAC spreadsheet. So the faculty members, they can directly enter the data in the spreadsheet. And once they complete it, will give the score. Just like NAC, it will give the score. For example, you can try this in the AQR itself. You can try. It will also look after library automation, office automation, and each and every student and staff have a unique ID to be managed under the MIS system. And this one is public fund management system provided by the central government. So all UGC funds and other central government schemes are covered under VFMS, MS. Of course, aided colleges and even self-financed colleges, suppose if they get a central government scheme, then they have to go for a VFMS system for monitor the public fund. So UGC and others, and you have to create a separate account for that. And you'll be given a unique ID for each vendor. If you want to pay money to a particular vendor, and the vendor has to be first registered, and a unique ID will be generated. So in that only you can pay them. So the payment will be through print payment advice, that is PPA as a system, and it has a control mechanism that the voucher has to be generated by the operator, and it has to be approved by an approver, and it has to be signed by the admin. The admin is supposed to be the principal, and finally the bank will pay. So the vouchers will be automatically created by this system, and you can give advance through PFMS just for 30 days, and it is working on the module, that is EAT module, enter and then approve and transfer module, and there is no reimbursement in the PFMS system, and all institution holding a 2F and 12B are supposed to go under the PFMS system. And e-governance in other important areas is academic audit, administrative audit, gender audit, social audit, and energy audit. There are, suppose if you look at the universities, they go for some 14 or 15 type of audits. But in college level, NAC, they ask you for academic audit, administrative audit, gender audit, and energy audit. So these audits can be done with simple Google Forms. You can create your audit form with a simple Google form, and share a link to the participant. They can open the link, give their suggestion, and once they submitted, we immediately instantly we will get a consolidated report. And so we have to develop a Google form for separately for each one, and the link should be available in the college portal. So in our institution, we have been done academic audit, administrative, and gender audit. And this year, we are thinking of doing energy audit. For example, I will tell you about the energy audit. In our institution, you may have thousands of lights, AC, and a lot of fan and laboratory instrument and all, and you may need a current for that. And your current, you can calculate the current bill. And what are the alternate energy source you utilize? For example, a solar system or a windmill for that. So what type of alternates used, and how much energy is conserved, or whether you come fully, completely depend on the alternate energy system and all. And even if you change, instead of going for a tube light, if you change an LED bulb, you can conserve some 40 to 50% of your energy. So these energy audit can be done with the help of a simple Google Doc and with your conventional current bill. So we have to combine these two things, and we can do it. And we can also apply the e-governance in the teacher profile on Google Form. It is a very difficult task for the IGSE to collect the information from the faculty members. In all institution, it is a hectic process. So instead of sending a circular and ask them to give the data and bring the data to the IGSE, later consolidate it. And so these are, instead of going through the conventional type, you can create a Google form separately for each staff. And the staff can directly upload periodically, maybe at the end of every month or after completing a particular event. Suppose if they publish a paper, they can immediately update. So each and every month, monthly interval or weekly interval, or fortnight interval, the faculty members can update their status in the Google form. That form can be can have the access to the IKSE, so that IKSE can collect the information just in a matter of second from the Google form. So just like that, scholarship, staff recruitment, and student WhatsApp profile to be told. and gateway for grievance and redressal itself. So most of the students have inhibition to give a complaint or express their grievance. Suppose if there is a e-governing system and some Google Forms are available in the portal and some helpline numbers are available in the portal, students can directly they will have the access and they can submit their grievance and they can get the reply. So everything will be governed with the digital system. And virtual meeting. This is nowadays almost, I think after Corona, each and every institution will follow this. Suppose if the principal wants to conduct a meeting, conventionally, we have to prepare a circular, you have to send a circular to the staff members, the staff members have to sign, and they have to come to a common room, and the common room should have electricity, and it will take 4 or 5 hours for this process. And some people may come earlier, some people may come late, and a lot of other disturbance and all. So now the virtual meetings through Zoom and Google Meet, WebEx, and a lot of other things. So we can connect people, thousands and thousands of people we can connect through the virtual meeting. Even in Zoom meeting also, in the free software, there are 100 people can enter into the Zoom room, whereas 1 lakh people can, the upper limit is 1 lakh, 1 lakh people can view through the YouTube. So there is a provision like that. So the e-governance, instead of calling all people and ask them to come to a particular room and conduct a meeting, it is now, nowadays, it is very difficult, very, very easy. So virtual meeting is one area in which the e-governance is highly applicable than IKAC. IKAC, e-governance is very, very, very essential for IKAC. The IKAC should have the members who are well versed with e-governing system. Even though they have different capabilities, the most common feature among the IKAC members should be the e-governing system. So each and every member should be aware of the e-governing system. So IKAC can utilize the e-governing for planning, management, execution, the data collection. I told you the Google Form to collect the data from the faculty members, then data analytics, and then you can do some predictive analysis also, then data retrieval, networking with the stakeholder, then information dissemination and communication, so consultation, review, so a lot of things. So actually, if you talk about the e-governance for IKAC alone, it will take at least half a day. We can explain so many things of the e-governance applicable to the IKAC. Okay. And this can be done through Google Drives, Google Forms, Google Sheets, and virtual meetings. And e-governance in library, it is one of the very important area. We have a software for that. For example, the Modern Libizer software. And in addition, we have NLIST, NDL, and NPTEL. These are all the e-governing system for a library. So instead of the conventional entry system, the library can have a barcode technology. Whenever a person enters into the library, the barcode will be scanned and it will register. And when they go out, it will also register. Like that, the library management modules, circulation modules, and students' search and inquiry modules, these are available in the library software. And it works in local area network, and all modules are fully integrated. And the transactions are also integrated. It caters the complexity of large library, and it is a multi-user. And salient features of the e-governing module of the library are all activities of the library's computerized issue, return, renewal, clearance, and fine payment, and a lot of other facilities. and you can generate some 135 different output reports from the software. So this is an excellent mechanism through which you can govern your library. And in addition to that, these are the central government schemes governed under the e-governance given to the library. There is a NLIST. So through NLIST, all institutions can register in the portal, and they can get a password. And from NLIST, hundreds of e-journals are available, and millions of e-books are available. You can share the e-resources with your student and faculty members. And all 12B and colleges which have 12B are eligible to enroll in the NLIST program, for which they have to pay some 5,900 rupees. And in case of unaided colleges, they have to pay 35,400 rupees per annum to avail the facility of the NLIST. Then NDL is another MHRD program to govern the e-resources, and it is for which also you have to register in the portal, and you can it is available in some 200 languages, and already there are 3 million users and 17 million content with more than 160 resources are available. And we can have utilize the NDL in different platform, including Android apps, iOS, and Windows, and all. And I want to highlight something. This is the largest online repository in the world, of course, in engineering, basics, and the selected humanities and social science subject. That is the NPTEL courses. It has 56,000 hours of the video content, and educational channels and subscribers, 90 million viewers, and 52,000 hours of transcribed content, and 51 hours of subtitle video. So you can become a member in the NPTEL, and your institution will be the local chapter for the NPTEL, through which you can access all these journals and the video content from the NPTEL portals. And another important area is student support and progress in. For example, I will tell you one or two examples. In our institution, we have registered some 2,500 students. They voluntarily registered for the blood donation. So we tested Department of Zoology and Department of Health of the Government of Tamil Nadu. We jointly organized a camp in the campus itself, and we tested the student, and 2,500 students they registered for blood donation. That data are digitalized and they are consolidated, and the data is available in the college website. Suppose a student or their parent, they need, in emergency condition, they need a particular blood groups, there is a helpline in the college website. So when you just click this blood donor helpline, it will immediately connect the principal or vice principal or the NSS staff and YRC. So you can tell them what type of blood you would like to get. So they have a instant access with the database, and they check it from department wise, student wise, male and female wise, and the village wise also. They can check and select the student, and they can give you the suggestion. So this type of thing can be governed, easily governed. So in every year, we come across some 15 to 20 emergency cases every year. So during those days, our students and parents, they need not go here and there. They can avail this facility, and it's purely governed by the governance. Okay. So these are the things we organized. Then insurance, another important thing we did in our institution is we insured all the students as well as the parents in the under personal accident scheme. So we have a digital database on the particulars of the student and their roll number and their address and their parents. So in case of any accident or emergency, if the student or someone is a relative or friend, they may be report to the institution through the helpline number. Immediately, we get the database and we collect the particulars and we will intimate to the insurance agency. This year, in the last 4 months, two parents have expired and one student has expired. So for each of them, we paid 1 lakh rupees. So all students and their parents are insured for 1 lakh rupees under the personal accident scheme. And this scheme is also governed under the e-governance. The helpline number is also available in the web portal through which you can report. And we process the application, everything we process through online. And only the parent or the student, they have to come here to give, to collect the check, that's all. Even the FIR copy, postmortem report and all medical bills and all, they can just scan it and just send it to us and we can consolidate and we will communicate to the insurance agency. Then placement, till I need not say much about this. So each and every institution, they should have a e-governing system for a placement cell. They should have a separate space in the web portal and there they have to give the notification application forms and they have to inform the prerequisites and the date and venue of the campus interview, and so they have to publish the selection list. Even the selection order may be given in the website. Just like that, anti-ragging cell and all. These are, so most of the students, they are afraid of giving a complaint, or they have an inhibition to go and meet a particular staff and give a complaint. Suppose there is a provision in the web portal, and there is a form, student can easily address their grievances through this. And just like that, anti-ragging cell also. And this is very, very important, extension activity. All extension activity can be governed under e-governance system. For example, in agriculture, suppose you have some 5,000 student. Your coordinator told me you have 5,000 students in your institution, and the institution is located in a rural area. If it is a rural area, definitely the parents may be from agriculture or some, they may have some animal husbandry system. So how can we govern an extension activity through e-governing system? We can have this type of virtual meeting, a particular date, a particular time. We can arrange experts from agriculture, experts from animal husbandry. We can ask them to sit here in our institution, and students may be intimated, and they can have a consultation. Their parents have a consultation and get the expert opinion. Suppose they have a field problem. Directly, a parent or student can just go to the field. And suppose your crop is infested with a pest, and they can just focus the pest with their mobile, and the expert who is sitting here, they can have the access. So immediately, the expert will look at the infested plant by the disease or pest, and he can give the solution. Otherwise, the farmer has to take up the plant to the agriculture extension office, and officers should be available there, and they have to give the suggestion. It will take a long time. It's a hectic process also. Here you can do it the e-governing system like this. The health awareness, sitting in your room, you can connect all your students, all your parents, and give a health awareness. For example, an awareness regarding dengue or chikungunya or COVID, or how to prepare a decoction. For example, how to prepare a kapas for a pudineer, or how to prepare a nilavengu pudineer, or how to do some first aid and all. You can sit here and connect people, health awareness, and you can connect the schools in your in and around your institution. So you can connect the students, you can connect the teacher, and from here you can give the extension activity to the schools, students also. And you can also give the information to the youth for employment, and some self-employment program also you can conduct, and it can be connected with the internet through the online program. So in our institution, actually, initially we had a tie with the Reliance Foundation under corporate social responsibility, and they have suggested us a toll-free number for online consultation. That number is given to all students and their parents. So whenever they come across, the students or parents, they come across any issues in the village, particularly in agriculture and animal industries sectors, they can consult through online with a toll-free number. And we can also arrange expert opinion and online discussion for that. But nowadays, since we are familiar with these online meetings and all, we can do the extension activity. We need not to depend on others. We can have a tie-up with, of course, a tie-up with a lot of some corporate offices, and we can directly do it. Even an extension activity, some students are doing some cleaning work or some other any work, you can directly telecast their work through YouTube. So otherwise, you have to take some photographs, you have to take some video clippings, and here you have to bring it, write a report and upload all those things. Now, at a time, lakhs and lakhs of people can witness the students' extension activity. So this is absolutely possible with the help of the e-governing system. I think this is enough for this day. So within a short period of 1 hour, I'm able to give only this much. And I thank the IPSC coordinator, the principal, and Professor Azira Banu for giving me such a wonderful opportunity to share my knowledge. Ma'am?
Yes, sir. Sir, very nice presentation, very informative presentation, sir. Some of the things are very new to us. We will implement in our college also.
Thank you, ma'am.
The session is open for discussion. Whoever want to participate in discussion, they can mute their mic and they can raise their queries.
Sir, you can ask your query now. Balu, sir.
Sir, first I thank you very much for your nice presentation, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Really, the session is highly informative and subjective, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, one clarification, sir.
Yes, sir, please.
During current pandemic situations, almost all higher education institutions are conducting the webinar on various topics throughout the nations.
Yes.
The current situation, school classrooms or virtual classroom is essential, no doubt, sir.
Yes, sir.
In your presentation, you told that classroom is better than actual classroom. Is it correct for all times? Yes. I think the actual classroom, face-to-face contact and interaction is very effective. It is my humble opinion, sir.
Of course. Not only that, sir. The cognitive sense of a teacher cannot be replaced by any book or any material or any video. So instantly, when a student he is intent to ask a question, and the teacher will think cognitively and he present his idea. Of course, physical classes or conventional classes are, of course, they have some very good advantages. Certain things which are very interesting, for example, that interactive presentation, I have given that example, you know. So that interactive presentation, you have a remote access with the student. They can't just switch on their phone, keep the laptop open and log in, and they can go away. We can monitor, we can ask a question, student ask, and we can answer. So it looks more with some pictures and videos and all. It's an alternative platform. I don't say we can replace the conventional classroom. Definitely it is not possible, because when they meet, students not only learn a subject, they learn interpersonal relationship, then attitude, culture, so many things they learn. So a conventional class cannot be replaced. Of course, I agree with you.
Oh, okay, thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Sir, I am Mohan from Commerce Zero Lawson Science College, sir.
Yes, sir, please.
Sir, I have one clarification, sir.
Yes, please.
For installation and access, is there any special training is needed, sir?
For which, sir?
For this e-governance facilities. Installation in our campus and getting access by the students and the staffs. Is there any special training is needed?
Sir, actually, sir, most of the things are available at free of cost. For example, Google Classroom is available at free of cost. And there is a paid version also. In paid version, we have some more advantages. But the basic feature is, should start with the basic feature is enough. And video tutorials are also available in the website on how to create a Google Classroom, how to create assignment, how to grade the student, how to evaluate, and how to insert your learning material. It is available in the Google, it is available in the YouTube, both in English as well as Tamil. But it may not be in the logical order. So actually, we requested our IQAC to organize online class for the faculty members. Mm. Of course, some 20% faculty members are already, they are well-versed. They independently learned from somewhere. Yes. But even though we asked the IQAC to organize 3 days, some online classes from the IT department, Professor Anandakrishnan, given the online class. And in addition to that, he conducted 3 days workshop also. So we went there and we raised questions, we got clarification and all. So we have so many different ways. Through we can learn through YouTube, and we can get online classes from your staff, or people like anybody can teach them online. To be very comfortable, initial training for 3 days will be very nice.
So because self-interested people can do all these things, sir.
Yeah, definitely.
But in the recent days, these are all mandatory.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So if training is there, that will do somewhat better.
And so it is the duty of the IQAC to plan. So IQAC has to identify the resource person, the right resource persons, and they have to organize the training. Actually, these tools are very simple. If the staff member have a laptop with the internet connection, it is very simple. And another one is recently Ramanujam College from the University of Delhi, they conducted the faculty improvement program. They are conducting 2 weeks program in which they give a lot of exercises and a lot of online tutorials. Very, very useful.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Good afternoon, sir. I am Ramesh from PSG College of Arts and Science, Coimbatore, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
Sir, your content was very elaborative, and I have a doubt regarding conducting audit through Google Form.
Yeah. Okay.
We need to have objective evidence for the data.
Audit.
So how to include it in Google Form?
In Google Form, there is a provision to upload the images, sir.
Okay, sir.
In images, you can have a lot of multiple choice question, descriptive choice questions, and suppose your faculty has completed your particular professor course or presented a paper, and there is a provision in the Google form to upload the image. They can just snapshot their certificate and they can upload the image in the Google form. So in the consolidated report, you will get the faculty wise, the name of the faculty, and for each question, how many research papers they publish, the titles, even the full length paper you can upload. In the Google form itself, you can upload the full length paper.
Sir, Vim's principal, sir, unmute yourself. You raised your hand.
Sir, good morning, sir.
Sir, good morning.
Sir, really an awesome session, actually, which we are talking about e-governance and e-learning is going on all over the world and also in India. Sir. And this is the right time, actually, for us to learn from you, expertise you, like you. Sir, and I'm so really new to hear this, actually. Like you told some rural area, like experts sitting in our institution and giving the solution to the rural people is really, I have not heard about this type of...
Imagine I am an agriculture expert. I am sitting in my room. You can organize this type of meeting, virtual meeting. And the farmer can go with their mobile farm and they can just focus the infrastructure plant or the paste they can focus. So I can directly view that. Or they can take some picture and share with me. I can... view it and give the suggestion. This is an online suggestion. So it is an excellent way to cover thousands of people with some experts. So every week or every fortnight, we can have a concrete schedule and a discussion on agriculture, discussion on animal husbandry, discussion on health, or some demo and all. So a lot of things we can do.
So how come you are taking it to the rural mass, actually, what you are doing, actually, whether through our students or through some notification to them, to all the farmers?
There are two options. One is NGOs and another one is a student. If you have a tie-up with the NGOs, they have small rooms and with TV and computer and all. They can gather people and they can communicate with me. And students, we have students, you know, almost every student have Android mobile.
Okay.
Mobile. So through the student, we can reach the parents.
Okay, sir. Because even it is a novel thing, which I am hearing, actually, because through our student, because many of the students who are studying with us is from rural area, where we can give this novel idea and we can have put it in the website also. It will also lead to an extension activity which is counted in ACK. And this is a very good idea, which today I got it from you, sir, actually. Really. And also you told some parents and students regarding that awareness of dengue, like dengue fever and everything. This is also one of the important things.
Suppose if you want to show the plant to Nilavembu. Okay. We are talking about Nilavembu Kudini here. And yes, Nilavembu decoction. You want to show Nilavembu to thousands of people from the rural area, and your students are there with their mobile. Okay. If I am showing the plant andrography spanulata, that is Nilavembu. Each and everyone can see that. Immediately they will understand the plant, and you can even demonstrate the preparation mechanism and all. Even some first aids, some clinical symptoms. See. One day, one night, you don't believe, at 2 o'clock in the night, one of my students he just called me. And he told his cow is having a severe diarrhea. Because the cow has consumed urea.
Okay.
And they could not get a doctor.
Okay.
So he asked me to give the suggestion.
Solution.
Now, first I told him to approach a doctor, but he said, sorry sir, no doctor is available, I am in a village. And I said, no problem, you just take a bucket of water and give the water to the cow. He said, no sir, the cow is not taking water. And I said, yes, I know the cow will not take, but you mix a handful of sugar and a handful of salt. You mix in that and give it. So it will compensate the water and the mineral loss and as well as energy loss. So he has given that one bucket of water, and the cow is next day morning he came and told me, sir, the cow is all right, he has given the right suggestion. Okay. Another day, a student, he is also in the night, he asked me, sir, we have a scorpion bite to my mother, sir, what to do, sir? I have suggested some things over phone. So these are the things we are suggesting over phone. But yes, they have an Android mobile, and okay, we can connect them, and we can easily the biting mark may be a dry bite. In case of snake, it may be a dry bite. If they have a multiple marking, it will be a dry bite. If they have one or two bites, so there is a chance for a venomous snake. So okay, if the student can focus it and show it to you from here, okay, itself, we can understand the symptoms and the markings, and we can give the suggestion. So these are things. It's just an example, but
yes,
we can do hundreds of things.
Yes, sir. Really, it was
the extension activity this year. We have planned like this. Previous okay year we went there, but this year, because the Department of Zoology is doing some unique things. For example, pest control in coconut trees with the pheromone traps. Mm-hmm. Instead of going okay for chemical pesticides, we organize a training for pheromone trap, pheromone tablet, how to install it and all. There's a lot of field activity. We go to the agriculture field and all, supported that. So hereafter, we can sit in our laboratory and show the pheromone trap, pheromone tablet, how to place it and how to install it and all. We can simply demonstrate it, and we can cover thousands and thousands of villages and parents through this e-governance.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Even connecting schools also is an all idea. Definitely, where we can give the school students.
Hereafter, you start connecting all schools to this.
After hearing you, we planned actually, sir. We already, I thought that really we have to make it school connectivity through e-governance, which will also lead to their employability, and we can teach something like what they are going to do in future.
Yeah, definitely, sir.
That will become an extension activity for us also, right?
Definitely. And at a time, we can connect many people, many schools and all. We physically go there, and it will take a lot of time, and we can cover only a limited students.
Sure, sir. If it is the order of the day hereafter, this e-governance will be playing a vital role in making all those things.
In fact, a small virus with the weight of a nanogram, it made a radical change in the world.
Yes, sir. You are true. And that's the reason why we are hearing from here your lecture. We may not able to get you through physical presence, but we are able to, thanks to Aeronauts and Science for bringing you here, and we are all hearing you, sir.
Have to thank Professor Amuda from our college and Professor Azira Panu from your college. They just asked me to give the lecture on e-governance, and then I accepted.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for the solution,
sir.
Please give your mobile number so that we can have any doubts. Definitely, that you can
93 603 203 20 20 559.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
GV Gopinath.
GV Gopinath.
Gopi for police.
Okay.
GV Gopinath at gmail.com. That is my email.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Sure, sir. We'll surely take your expertise for our future listings. Yeah,
okay.
Thank you so much, sir.
And in case of organic farming and all, we can do a lot of things in agriculture and animal activity. We can do a lot of things, a lot of training and all. Even self-employment, for example, honeybee rearing, you can give the training through online. You can just have the live transaction and mushroom culture. We can give self-employment training to the youth through live screening and all.
Okay, sure, sir. Sure, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, Principal, sir, from Vivekananda Institute. Sir, there's one more question, sir, in the chat box.
Please, ma'am.
Should the energy audit be approved by any external appropriate body, or the approval of the principal will do?
Actually, madam, this is internal auditing only. It is internal auditing. The approval of the principal is necessary because we have evidence. We have evidence of our current electricity bill, okay? And once you do some alternatives, for example, if you replace all the tube lights or CFL bulb with the LED bulb, immediately your current bill will decline. That will reflect on your EB bill, okay?
Okay.
So we can create the evidence very easily. And nowadays, NAC is asking GPS enabled photographs. Suppose if you said I have installed a solar panel, then you have to go there, enable the GPS camera, and you have to take the picture. So it will inform the NAC from which latitude and longitude that particular panel is installed. So the evidence can be also brought under e-governance.
Okay.
So internal auditing is enough.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Any other questions from the participants?
Sir, this is Hajira Banu, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, you said that online examination can be conducted through Google Classroom. For class-wise, it's good, sir. When we go for online examination for a college, then whether it is possible through this online mode like Google Classroom, or otherwise you can suggest any other.
Ma'am, in paid version, we have a separate features. For example, if a student log in into the online exam, immediately all other apps will be shut down. He can't come back. He can't open another website, and he can't search the result. And the camera will be automatically open. We can monitor the student. We can monitor his screen, everything and all. So in paid version, there is a provision like that. For example, in this webinar also, you want to give the certificate to the participants for which they have to register the registration link, and they have to give the feedback form and all. But in the paid version, there is a facility called attendance facility. So it will immediately note down who are entered into the login and how long they are in the class. And when they left, everything, it will be, it will automatically generate the attendance. So in paid feature, we have some more options.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Very clear and valuable presentation, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
I think Sivakumar, sir, wants to come up with a query. Yes. Sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, you can unmute and you can raise your query. Any other participant, do you have any query? You can come forward.
Sir, there is a question in chat box.
Yes.
Whether the data collection for research through online process will be authentic?
Whether the data collection for research
through online process will be authenticated or not, they are asking.
Sir, good afternoon, sir.
Yes, sir, please.
Good afternoon, sir. I am Sivakumar, head of the Department of Commerce, Aditya College.
Yes, sir. Please, sir.
According to internal audit, how will you prepare for the each and every department, sir? What are the criteria we are going to be considering preparing for the internal audit, sir?
Internal academic audit, sir. Actually, in our institution, we cover that 360-degree questionnaire, you know, there is a questionnaire which covers the 360 degree questionnaire. I suggested by Allahabad University. They have given a lot of questions in which your publications and then professor course, workshops, everything we covered, and they have also allotted mark. For university, there is a separate module, and for college, there is a separate module. So we adopted the module for the module suggested for the college. And we can, it is an internal mechanism, madam, internal audit only. Internal audit. So you can add any question comfortably, and you can manipulate the grading, everything you can, according to your situation.
In our college, affiliated college, sir, affiliated college, what are the criteria we would be considered, sir?
Actually, we are just following the format suggested by the Allahabad University, and we submitted the same report to the NAC. No problem. We submitted report for more than 7 years. We submitted the report.
Okay, sir. Okay.
If you want to have the format, could you please mail me? I will send you the format. No,
okay sir, such a clear, crystal clear and nice presentation. Thank you so much.
Then the another question, whether the data collection for research through online process will be authenticated. I think there is no doubt in that. Nobody has raised such a question, and nobody has said you should not collect the data through online mode. There is no such guidelines given in any institution. So we can collect it through online.
Hajira, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Please go ahead with the formal vote of thanks.
Okay, ma'am. Good afternoon, one and all connected here. I take this opportunity to propose vote of thanks and acknowledge the contribution of everyone who have directly and indirectly contributed to make this program happen. I express my heartfelt gratitude to our beloved chairman and secretary, Sri K.K. Balusami sir, who always motivate us, inspire us from his vision and mission. I extend my gratitude to our honorable principal sir, Dr. R. Venkatacharam sir, for his guidance and support to organize such a useful program. I am immensely thankful to our most respected controller of examination, Dr. M. Venkatacharam sir, for his support and sharing of ideas to make this program a fruitful one. Our sincere thanks to our esteemed resource person, Dr. G.V. Gopinath sir, assistant professor of zoology, Armugam Pillai Sitayammal College. We are really enlightened with your knowledge and presence, sir. Especially your deep insight on e-governance, its implementation in administrative and academic. It would be really helpful to us to enhance the quality education. Thank you, sir. We are very much thankful to you. Behind every successful program lies a manifold effort of committed faculty. Yes, it's none other than IQSC coordinator, Dr. S. Jayasudha ma'am, and IQSC members. I wholeheartedly express my gratitude to them. I would like to express my gratitude to all the partakers of this program who are sincerely committed to this event to make it success. I specifically thank the people who have been the backbone of the event. Our technical support staff, Mr. Muruganandam sir, assistant professor of maths, V. Maheshwari, assistant professor of BCom CA, Mr. Kavin Prabhu sir, for their technical support. Thank you everyone for their support.
Thank you, ma'am. From the bottom of the heart.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, from the bottom of the heart. Sir, express my sincere thanks to you and the IQC coordinator, your principal, and your chairman.
Thank you, sir.
This opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We got many inputs on e-governance. We will surely take up and we'll go with it, sir. Really very informative, sir. Thank you, sir.
Shall we leave the meeting?
Yeah. Okay, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Hajira, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Thank you.
Ma'am, thank you very much.
Yes, what? I must really thank you. You are the first person to go identify a resource person and you have brought that till this day. Yeah? You were sticking on. That's how I will do it well. Yes, we got many inputs, ma'am. Really good. We will make an analysis and then request our principal, sir.
Sure, ma'am. Sure, ma'am.
Adhira, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
I think Jagada ma'am malli add ayyadi iniki.
Ah yes sir, I expected her.
Illa ma'am was there but she has left. Sir, I think you can stop the YouTube live stream.
5 minutes for YouTube and the other project. Feedback click. Yeah, I'm getting the 2 minutes delay.
Okay. சரவணன் சார் இன்னைக்கு ஸ்லோ மோஷன்ல கூட வரமாட்டேங்கிறாரு.
மேடம்
சார் பாருங்க பாடிட்டு
Hello.
Live stream. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You're audible, please. Live stream will be.